Sam, I took a little break from the streaming for the last couple of days. I was kind of just relaxing and traveling a little bit. Here we are. It's been a little bit of an anxious day. We had a pretty big power outage in the East Bay, so I'm a little anxious. I've had a little bit of work to do this morning. But we're gonna go ahead and just do a lunch game. It's a late lunch today for me. It's already after one, but I worked through lunch today, so we'll give it a shot and see how it goes. Let's check the preferences. Okay, looks good. We'll do a fast game. Auto match. There we go. Looks like I'm playing BL. It looks like he's into Fallout or something. Yeah, it's a Fallout thing. Hi there. Hi, good game. 3K, we'll see how I do. Okay, diagonal star point. Okay, yeah, I play this a lot. Sometimes they like to pincer here and be a little tricky. More often than not, they just attach. Yeah, that's what I thought. So I've been trying to work this pincer a little bit, but I'm not that good at it. I think I'll give it a shot though. I think this is the more modern style, the more commonly played style to take the 3-3. And I think I actually might be able to do it to completion. I think this is old school, just diagonally, just a Kasumi here. So we'll try it. See how far I can remember. Was not expecting that. I was expecting him to just play d16. Okay, so I guess I can just play this. And I'm not sure what to do here, actually. Do I extend out? Do I jump? Diagonal counter pincer? Or pincer now, I guess? Don't really like leaving this spot open. Feels like I need to play back here. Because if I don't, then he'll play here, and then what, I'll cover, and then I'll cut? No, I don't like that. Kick. Kick. Play down. Jump. Play down. Tiger's Mouth. I think I don't like him playing this. Maybe I'll just play this. I'll just try to play this. This might be terrible idea, but we'll see what happens. Okay. So he extends. I mean, obviously, it seems like he wants to make this side good, and I guess he knows he can jump here, and that makes me run even more. Can I play down here? Is this Mi'ai to jump or to live easily? I think maybe it is. So I'm gonna just maybe get started on it. Is this a. That would just force him to attack me immediately. Maybe I should just jump out. I should just jump out. I guess my other option would be to approach over here. That seems like I'm leaving something behind here that I shouldn't be leaving behind quite yet. Maybe I can attach here. I think I like this. Then maybe I can follow up by playing over here, and then at least I'll have some center group opening up. Maybe that will make him jump out to K17, and then I can play D11, which he'll block, and maybe I can build out towards the center here. Maybe that'll work. It might not be a good result for me, though. I mean, these sides, I'd much rather have territory than this. But I made a plan, so I'm gonna do it. Hey, Snedberg, how's it going? This is one of those things. It might be a bad plan, but it's a plan, so I need to do it and learn from it being a bad plan. It's better to learn from a bad plan than it is to not have a plan and not learn. I still think all he needs to do is play, just approach over here, and all of a sudden it puts me in a weird spot. Like I'd be happy to have this on the side and the side up here, and I sort of I'm sort of considering that, Stenberg. I'm kind of thinking maybe I should try for the center here, at least in this side. I generally do really well when I play for influence. Oh, that was very. This seemed really. I mean, you might call it calm. I might call it slow, because it seems like I could. Oh, maybe I shouldn't. I feel like I should take one of these. Maybe just back off here. Yeah, this seems like to focus on the center, which seems to coincide with this nicely. If he approaches over here, then I can, I guess, pincer jump. If I play here and he approaches over here, then I can just back off. I kind of like playing this. I kind of like playing this. If I play this, he'll probably what approach me up here, and then I can pincer. I'm gonna do it. I can't say I like this idea for me. This is a little scary because he's got nice territory in the lower left. He's got a little bit of territory up top. Not a lot on the left, but I mean he could finish this easily enough just by like a knight's move or a double knight's move or something like that. Could attach, but I don't like that. Kick. Don't like that either. I don't like that attach. I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't like it. Pincer high, like this, two space high or one space high. That's kind of interesting. I don't like it. I don't like it. Low pincer, I guess the thing about that is that he could just counter pincer me here, and then that would force me to run, then force him to run, and then I would run over here. I would get territory on the side. I'd have a weak running group, and he'd be advantage. He'd have the advantage. Shoot. I guess I'm just gonna do it. I haven't done this one for a long time. Sure. Not sure which one I like. I never know which one of these to make. I think this is more normal, but I like this one for some reason. It might leave a weakness or something. I don't know though. Maybe this is better with this stone here. I don't know. I'm just gonna do that. Well, I got some outside influence like I wanted. Oh man, I've got hot water. I don't even have decaf. My thing says I've got decaf, but I don't. I have hot water. I use this junky Nescafe decaf because it's can make it fast. Okay. Turn there, huh? Okay, why not? How's that for ballsy? Or stupid, one of the two. I don't know. I can't tell the difference at my level. It could be both. It could be ballsy and stupid. It's like a guy that's got an enemy line in front of him firing, like everyone's firing their guns, and he just says, "Let's go!" And he runs forward, and he's the only one that runs forward, so. We'll see. Kind of wasn't expecting that. Kind of. I guess it could be troublesome. Makes me run a little bit, but it kind of puts a lot of pressure on these stones over here, even though he turned around here. He's making his side group pretty stressed out, I think. Can I create any havoc? Yeah, it's a late launch. There's a power outage, a huge power outage around here today, so. So my lunch is starting a little bit later. If I Hane here. And then sort of peep here. Then he blocks. And I play down. And then I cut. And then he Ataris. And I play down. That doesn't do anything for me. What if I do this and then this? Atari first, Hane, then Atari, then jump. Hane, Hane, Atari, fill, attach, split, Atari, Atari, defend. Let's try it. Oh, he's probably going to Atari on the outside. Maybe I can cross cut? Why would he Atari through the inside? That's crazy. Should have read that one out, but I don't have time. I need to start playing slower games. Maybe I can clamp? Clamp. If I can play here. I'm gonna try this. I got sidetracked with this stupid thing. Terrible little fight. Kind of fight I should try to avoid. It's obvious to me that this was a wrong way to play over here. Maybe I should have just approached up here and played simply. No need to pick a fight. What, he'll probably just back off here. G8, and then what? I'll jump again here, threaten to connect here, so he'll come out and... Then what? Kosumi? I guess I can do this first. Crosscut. Crosscut. Now this. I don't want to make him strong first. Maybe we should just play here first. Just play here first. There's no doubt. I mean, he's going to play E10, and then I'm just going to play F9. Hey, Pistol Pete. Hmm. The odds of me living are not good. What's he gonna do? Play G11? Yeah, of course. Maybe I can do this. Blah, 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 blah. Maybe I can just keep pushing. Kasumi, this is bad for me, but I think I'm at least out now. And he's got something big going on the bottom, which is terrifying to me, but maybe I can make up for it on the right. And you know, this group for white is still kind of, it's still not settled. It's still kind of risky for white to leave that. So if he gets a move in here to try to fix this white group, then I'm just going to play down here to try to reduce. Maybe I'll even play a shoulder hit here. That's probably too deep. Maybe I'll play here. K5. K5 might even be too deep. Maybe I could just play K6. I don't know anything to try to prevent this from being so big. Do I want to ignore that? I think I do want to ignore that. I think I'm gonna ignore that. Okay, wait, wait. I think he, huh. That's so small. I really want to make a box up here on the right side, but I really don't want to put any more on this group. This is it's already, I think that this is already starting to weigh. It's already starting to bend under the pressure of this group and this group. I think if white played out here and capped or something like that, I might be able to play down here and settle somewhat small down here, so I'm not too nervous about it yet. But I would force myself to do that, I think, by approaching up here. Would it be worth it? Because then he could have Sente to play up here. I think I'm just going to do this right now while I can. Does this get me anything else down here? This is a pretty goofy idea. Maybe I should just try to get big. Maybe I should just pressure loosely like that. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. This is interesting, I think, because I've got it set up to try to do low latency, but I don't know how well that'll work, Stenberg. Okay, that's what I wanted. This is actually what I wanted, which is rare. It's rare that I get what I want. Because now I have something over here. Now he'll probably just jump out or attach, maybe. But if he attaches, then it'll strengthen this top corner. I was thinking about just hopping on and doing a bunch of Go problems today. Just opening up Go Grinder and doing that because lately I have not been feeling like playing so much. I've just been on a losing streak. Last week I think I lost like 5 games in a row. Okay. My natural inclination here is to try to overconcentrate. Well, you've already invested 2 stones. Yeah, I thought M6 was good enough as a reducing move. It also ex it was kind of like the frontier along the that this territory. So if I wanted to keep building up the center, I might as well play here. And then it also at least get me. It was basically like a free Sente move, I felt, so I could play this, play so I could play M17 before. Before yielding Sente, before playing Gotame. I should be able to benefit from this. It looks like White's put himself in a little bit of a predicament, forcing me to have good shape. Do I need to respond to this when he cracks, when he fixes this? I don't think I do. It's one of those things where I'd be nervous not to. Okay. This seems pretty natural. This seems pretty natural, but it lets him get out, right? Maybe extend one more time? I don't think there's any harm in just hitting him on the head. He's gonna fix this, and then I can fix this, and he's still in a tight spot, and I'm still building territory, or, you know, influence in the center. Can I double Hane now? Let's see now. If I double Hane here, he'll cut me here. I'll defend here. I think I can. I think I can, because I think he still owes a move down here. I felt okay with O15. Just because of M17. Otherwise, I would have just played O16. This was probably stupid. It was impulsive of me, but I need to be more mindful of my time. It was a terrible shape play, but at least it's Sente. Yeah, at least it's Sente. Might still be. Nah, no, it's not. So he lived down here. I got a corner. Corner is okay, but it doesn't compare to his bottom at all. I've got two weak groups on the board. I think he's probably, if I was to just throw out a number, I'd say the white's still looking good by about 25 points, at least. This bottom is really big. I need to either get in here or tear this up. I feel maybe my estimation is too great. I don't think he should feel compelled to play another move on this group. This group is alive. If he does, that's a free move. Oh, he feels like shenanigans. He feels like doing something. Interesting. Let's see. What can he do here? Can he do anything here? Is this too much? I think it's too much. I'm just going to try to play simple. I don't think that that's going to work out. I mean, I guess he can connect under, right? No, he can't. Yeah, he could. He can connect under and over. Yeah. I want to do what I can while I can. This is terrible. This two space here is going to probably be the death of me, but the only way I justify it is because I have to do something up here, and I think that if he tries to cut it, I might be able to squiggle in here. I might be able to, I don't know. Like that, you know? This is problematic, right? But not really. I think I can still do it and see what happens. I'll take the Panuki. Wasn't expecting that. I'll take it. This is probably a bad idea. I don't even know if he has to respond to that. I mean, he can get out of here. Only if he feels like that could risk his shape. Or that could threaten his shape. I don't know, maybe if I was him, I'd feel far enough ahead to actually respond. Better be something good. Well, I guess he's got a local. You just extend. Yeah, just extend. He can't see that local threat. Oh, okay, well. I'll just kill your top group. Yeah. That's life. That happens. Oh, I wasn't expecting that. Oh geez, I'd be terrified if I was this guy right now. Let's just do this. Ah, it's still big. I mean, it should live, unless he lets me get away with way too much stuff. Okay, well, I'll pick a fight then, why not? Okay. Probably not the best response. Okay, this is bad. No bueno. About that. Is that too calm? I think I need more than that. Jeez. Maybe this is something. This could be a hallucination, but what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to figure out if there's a way to... I mean, he can always jump here and probably find a second eye easily. Try to cut here or here. Yeah, it's a pretty crappy idea, I'll admit that. I have to defend this, otherwise he's going to get me. This is just about making sure that this group stays out. Yeah. Was not expecting that. I feel like I should be able to benefit from this. Yeah, this is a bad thing going on here. Maybe not. Let's try this. Yeah, this bottom is way too big. There just needs to be a way to cut this, but I don't think there is. Okay. Yeah, that was probably not the best move for me. Because it kind of lets this group get weak on the left. And it doesn't really, I mean, he gets connected down here, I think, to L6 now. It's all forcing too, which is kind of lame. Yeah, and it doesn't even let me cut over here at H12. Totally useless. Now you can just connect here. Oh boy, I don't have a lot of options left. And he plays away. That's surprising to me, actually. Because it just gave me a few more options. Should I play safe? Play here? I'll play here. It surprised me. I'd be pretty sketched out if I was right now. I mean, you know that all you have to do is make one more eye, but you gotta make one more eye. That's another eye. Now it's a fake eye. He's in a bit of a pickle. I don't think it's that bad, though. As bad as it looks. What if I just do this? I'm gonna try to just do this first. Ah, it gives him his eye. Yeah. Key. That's a bummer. Let's see. This is officially scary. Yeah, it's too bad. Yeah, it's too bad. I don't think there's any hope. What? Why would you play away like that? What? Thanks, I think. Okay, let's review. That was a big fight, but I know, right? I guess, I swear to God, I'm on a losing streak, and the first time I win, it's because some guy fucking resigns when he's winning by 5 million points. Oh, somebody was fine. Stones and Atari, M13 captures. Oh, what's your name on Twitch? Who is this guy? Who is this guy? BL. There's no BL here. Ah, okay. So I think it's kind of cheating if you're watching me stream a game when you're playing me. That kind of gives you an idea of where I'm, what I'm thinking about. Let's start at the beginning. This is what, called an orthodox opening or something like that. This happens all the time. This doesn't, though. I'm used to seeing, and I mean, it's fine. It works. It's just that this is, I'm usually on autopilot to play something like this. You know? The fact that there was a pincer is good because it forces me to practice variations that I'm not used to playing. But then when I try to play them, I expect them to go I expect them to go something like, what was I thinking? Oh, what's it called then? I don't know the names of these openings. What's the continuation for this? I mean, I was playing with it a little bit, and I know that there's that, which is old school, and that, which is new. Oh, okay, it's just an opening. That's fine. I like that kind of name. Well, I don't know, you know, with the de with Sick Willy, with the delay in the streaming and everything like that, the review might be a little strange, but I mean, you can hop onto the game if you want. On KGS. I actually don't know how this is supposed to go. Oh, hey, Sick Willy, the one Dan. Go ahead. I only have about another 15 minutes, though. So, that's right. That's what I was looking for. Yeah. I know this one, sort of. Yeah. Black takes the top, and white takes the left in this variation. Yeah. And then black can tanuki. I would probably, being a single di digit key, probably just extend to make use of, immediately make use of that. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. This I had no idea how to respond to. Yeah, I was looking at that one. I played that recently and just felt so over-concentrated. It was the key point, it just. Oh, I see. That's what I had forgotten was the C18 after the B15, so you get a solid corner, you get life in the corner. You get a settled black gets a settled group, white gets top and a little bit on the left, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, I wasn't really sure how to play it, so I played this weird kind of let me spend a lot of moves and try to make something in the center. It didn't seem very efficient. A high pincer here, huh, was one of the options I decided to attach. I usually don't play that. I played that for a long time. I play that often, but I usually don't play this attach. This was probably what, too deep? A little suicidal, little kamikaze guy. Maybe should have just played M17. I don't know. So what, even a kick would have been better then? Still bad, but not as bad. How about 05? Yeah, I probably would have played this too. That just doesn't know what it wants to do? Is that too soft? This seems like it'd be too good for white. Yeah. Goate makes white happy in the bottom. Big on the bottom all of a sudden. Yeah. This seemed like this is like a big mistake by White. I thought, to kick me here? I don't think I necessarily should have extended. Maybe I could have done a one space jump, like e6 or something like that. Yeah, I know. Okay, kick is fine. Is it still not enough? Not light enough? Yeah, I don't play this a lot. I don't play this attach a lot. I should really become more familiar with it. I guess key point is that there's lots of options for reducing. I just didn't have to do something so risky. Yeah, I read this out up to it, but I expected the wrong thing. I expected that Sitari just makes white strong. I was trying to set it up to cut with e5, but he Hanayd on the outside. I didn't read that. I expected him. It's one of those things where my reading is biased towards like the first position that I expect him to respond at. Yeah, I mean I should also I mean I was just reading it in a way that favored me, not white, so I thought about the cross connect. The cross cut, yeah. Yeah, that I couldn't convince myself to do it. Not happy for black. The bottom is magnificent. If I was white, I would just play calmly and, play up at like M6 or something like that and take huge territory on the bottom and be happy. Yeah, but I felt like I needed to have some dream come true because those groups on the left were so miserable. I kind of thought that I had Miaia on the top left group, so I thought that, I could play c18 or I could jump out at k, or j or k15, something like that, and still run, but I knew that I had that group on the bottom left that was just going to keep on running, so. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I thought that he would be forced to protect that. I'm surprised that he didn't. I mean, he was forced to protect that eventually. It's just that he allowed me to kind of build up quite a bit before doing it. Quite satisfied with that result, but then I just did this. I don't know why. This is one of those. Yeah, I should just play on the outside. Play on the outside, force and reduce liberties from the outside. Yeah. That's a big corner. Yeah. Oh yeah. Definitely. It's a, 15-point swing, 10-point swing at least, 10-point swing. I probably shouldn't have gotten into this ko. I think this was the wrong time to pick this ko. And as a matter of fact, I'm really surprised that he didn't play this local threat of just extending. You know? He had that and he just decided to not play it. I like it. Yeah, I like it. Well, I don't think I needed to pick that ko. I don't think that ko was a good idea. I don't even think that was a threat. I think he just responded to it because we were in Biyoyomi. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it wasn't either when I played it. Yeah, I mean, I can't do anything. There's nothing I can do there. I mean, I can make dead shape inside. Sure, I can do that. No. That corner should have been worse off, I think. The fact I was able to live there so quickly doesn't seem right. I knew the Jiseki, I just didn't play it. Yeah, just cut. Yeah, I don't know why I didn't do that. Those three black stones are looking pretty sad. I think that he entertained me a little bit too much here by letting me cut there. That way, huh? I got it. Cut. Cut. Yeah, forcing move was really annoying. I was really surprised he didn't do that, actually. It really allowed me to play that knight's move and really kind of look like I was sep or surrounding him a bit more. Very, very surprising to me. It's like he had that group out. He just needed to make a jump. No, there's a capture right there. He's got a group in Atari. Oh, we missed it? No, I didn't. I didn't. Oh, I guess I did. Oh, that's weird. Yeah, my fighting is the only thing I've got going for me because everything else sucks. My opening, I guess my end game is okay. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. I can make a false eye on the bottom. I can turn that into a false eye. Yeah. This was, oof. I still think you were ahead on liberties, man. Yeah. Can't believe that group was there, sitting there. Yeah, pass would have been better, right? Yeah, that was hard. That was a good game. Anyways, I gotta get back. It's been a little over an hour now, so I should probably get back to the grindstone. I'm on call, so. In the game. I have to get back to work. Yeah, I should strive to take, if that's my takeaway for this game, is that I should have a nice solid set of groups after, once I enter the mid game. I should strive to not have a single weak group or weak looking group after the end game. I'll try to implant that in my brain, but it's got to get past all that jello. Yeah. Oh, it's okay. Oh, yeah, I don't mind. You can do the review mostly for me. That's fine. Gonna shut down the stream, but you can feel free to keep reviewing with BL if you want. I can leave. I mean, the game can stay open, of course. So I gotta shut the stream down though and get back to it. So, see you guys later. Bye.